सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ पूर्णमदः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः ॐ आप्यायन्तु ममाङ्गानि वाक् प्राणश्चक्षुश्रोत्रमथो बलमिन्द्रियाणि च सर्वाणि सर्वं ब्रह्म उपनिषदं माहं ब्रह्म निराकुर्यां मा ब्रह्म निराकरोत् अनिराकरणमस्त्वनिराकरणं मे अस्तु तदात्मनि निरतेय उपनिषत्सु धर्मास्ते मयि सन्तु ते मयि सन्तु ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादम् शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेदि भेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः ॐ इत्येतदक्षरमुद्गीतमुपासीत ॐमिति ह्युद्गायते तस्योपव्याख्यानम् देवादिवद् अपि लोके क्षीरबद्धि एंड देवादिवद् दिस टू सूत्रास आंसर टू इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चंस दैट असहायम ब्रह्म दैट ब्रह्म इज विदाउट एनी सहाय नॉर्मली इन द वर्ल्ड Someone like a pot maker or a weaver, they require a lot of supporting accessories to accomplish the task of creation. But you say that Brahman is ekameva dvitiyam, there is nothing other than Brahman, asahayam Brahman, Brahman is no sahaya. Then how can Brahman create? So therefore, these were the arguments. ब्रह्म न उपादानम असहायत्वात् केवल मृद्वत् लाइक मियरली क्ले कैनॉट क्रिएट विदाउट द हेल्प ऑफ द पॉट मेकर सो ऑल्सो मियर ब्रह्मन कैनॉट बी द मटीरियल कॉज वंस अगेन ब्रह्म जगत है न निमित्तम असहायत्वात् केवल कुंभकारवत् और ब्रह्मन कैनॉट बी निमित्त कारण ऑल्सो बिकॉज Like a pot maker alone cannot create without the help of the clay, so also Brahman cannot create. So first question was answered, Kshiravaddhi, like Kshira, the milk, does not require any external aid in order to get transformed into curd, etc. If you say that you have to heat the milk, you have to add the curdling agent, they merely accelerate the process, but potentially milk is possessed of the ability to get transformed. Similarly, Brahman can be possessed of the ability to get transformed. In case of milk, of course, you require heating the milk, you require curdling agent to enhance its ability to get transformed, but Brahma is paripurnam, paripurna shaktikam. Brahma possesses all the shakti, all the power that is required to get transformed. Therefore, it does not require any external aid. Second one was chetanaha puna kulaladayaha. So it's all right in case of kshira or the milk, which is achetanam, but the kulala is chetana, and then those who are so chetanatve sati asahayatvat. One more qualification was added, that not only Brahman is asahayam, without any support or without any help, it is chetanam, it is conscious. Like a pot maker is a conscious being, and therefore he requires clay and other things. Devadivat api loke. But now here the exception is given or shown, how in case of devatas, pitrus, rishis, etc. Mahaprabhavaha, those with great power capabilities. Aishwarya Vishesha Yogad, on account of their possessing a specific greatness or glories or powers. Anapekshava Kinchit Bahyam, without the need of any external help, how devatas, pitrus, rishis are able to create. Bahuni Nana Samsthanani Sharirani, they can create many other bodies. Prasadadini, palaces, etc. Rathadini, chariots, etc. So even for a conscious being, if the conscious being is possessed of Mahaprabhava, possessed of Aishwarya Vishesha. So yesterday one sentence was not read on the page 298. So just because a kulala or a pot maker is not able to create without any help, does not mean that that rule applies to every conscious being. The conscious being, such as devatas, pitrus, rishis, who are possessed of specific powers or outstanding powers, they can create. They are known to create. And Brahman also is possessed of course, achintya shakti, incomprehensible powers or ability, and therefore that it can create, what to say. And therefore this siddhe vibhichare phalitam sutratatpiram upasamharate, that in this logic chetanetva sati asahayatvatva asahayatvat na jagat karanam brahma. So there is a vyabhichara, an exception in the devatas, etc. The Vashyakara concludes the page 398 in the last sentence. Tasmad yatha ekasya samarthyam drishtam tatha sarvesham eva bhavitum arhati iti नास्ते एकांतः इत्यभिप्रायः. तस्मात् यथा एकस्य सामर्थ्यं दृष्टम्, So just because you see samarthyam or lack of samarthyam, just as because a pot maker is not possessed of those powers and therefore is not able to create without the aid of external factors, does not mean that that will apply to every conscious being. Or just as Brahma is possessed of, or devatas are possessed of special powers and they were able to create, does not mean that every conscious being such as a pot maker should be able to do. So there is upadhi, there is again now a distinguishing factor here. Samarthya sati, when achintya power is there, achintya shakti is there in case of Brahman, that there is that rule that is applies to a pot maker does not apply to Brahman. No, ekantah, it's not an invariable rule that what applies to one conscious being should necessarily apply to all conscious beings, because the powers of different conscious beings are different. And paripurna shakti kami brahma, Brahma is possessed of all the shakti of the powers, therefore it can create. So possibilities are shown here by logic. By logic, the position that Brahman is Jagat Karanam, that's the theme here. Throughout this pada of the quarter, the theme is Jagat Karanam Brahma. Because in the first chapter, this was the conclusion arrived at. Janmadyasya Yataha. That Brahman is the cause of the Janma, Sthiti, Bhanga of this entire universe. And that was established in the first chapter, Samanvayadhyaya. And that becomes the Vishaya, means that is being questioned from different standpoints. And the doubts are resolved one by one. Now on the page 398, if you go to the next sutra, we'll just review it. Krishna prasakti nirvayavatvat nirvayavatva shabda kopova, that's the sutra. Krishna prasakti, now this is a Purupaksha sutra, says Krishna prasakti. Purupaksha says, please tell us whether Brahman is nirvayavam or savayavam. Is Brahman homogeneous, partless, or is it heterogeneous, possessed of internal differences or internal parts? Please tell us. Krishna prasaktihi. Brahman in its entirety will undergo transformation. Niravayava Brahma Pariname. If you say Brahman is niravayavam or partless, then now it is established that Brahma is Jagat Karanam. So Brahman undergoes the transformation to become Jagat. They are now coming to Vivartavada. Slowly the discussion is veering towards Vivarta. Now, all right, Brahman is Jagat Karanam, all right. But then how does Brahman, does it become Jagat? Does it get transformed as Jagat? If Brahman is Niravayavam, partless, then that means the whole Brahman should undergo transformation. If Brahman possesses parts, then one amsha can undergo transformation and the rest need not. There's a whole lump of clay, you can take a part of it and make pot out of it, and part of it and make something else out of it. Because the clay is savayavam, it consists of, you know, it's a composite entity. If Brahman is niravayavam, is a homogeneous entity, ekarasam, homogeneous, partless, and still it undergoes transformation to become Jagat, that means the entire Brahman should undergo transformation to become Jagat, then Brahman is no more. Just as a seed undergoes transformation to become a sprout, and seed is no more. Or a lump undergoes transformation to become part, the lump is no more. Similarly, Brahman also undergoes transformation as Jagat, Brahman is no more. So, Krishna prasakti, wholesale transformation, either Krishnasya brahmanah कार्याकारेण परिणाम प्रसक्ति ही द एंटायर ब्रह्मन ब्रह्मन इन एंटायरिटी विल अंडरगो ए ट्रांसफॉर्मेशन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ कार्य जगत विच इज नॉट एक्सेप्टेबल. We want that Brahman should remain Brahman and then still Jagat should be created. Not that Brahman should not remain Brahman anymore. Niravayavatva shabda kopova. Therefore you say, no, Brahman is savayavam. Brahman is possessed of internal parts like a tree. It's a composite entity, it's an aggregate of different components. Suppose you say, then niravayavatva shabda kopova, then that position of yours will militate against or contradict the revelation of the Upanishad that Brahman is niravayavam, nishkalam, says nishkalam, nishkriyam, shantam. Brahman is nishkalam, partless. So, see, Brahman cannot undergo transformation. The whole idea is the Purvapaksha is very beautiful Purvapaksha. That even though by logic you have shown the possibility that Brahman being conscious can become the cause of creation, and you claim that Brahman is both the material cause as well as efficient cause, but a material cause should undergo a transformation to become the effect. Like the clay undergoes transformation to become a pot. If Brahman in its entirety undergoes transformation, then there is no more Brahman. Then there is no more moksha. If Brahman is not there, what I would know? Tattva aham brahmasmi. Where is Brahman? And if part of Brahman undergoes transformation, then that will contradict Upanishad's statement that Brahman is partless. Therefore, Brahman cannot be upadana karanam, cannot be material cause. That's the Purvapaksha. So the answer is given in the next sutra, Shrutestu Shabdamulatvat. Tu Shabdene Akshepam Pariharati. But no, however, Shabda Shrutehe, so Shabdamulatvat. श्रुते ब्रह्मण जगत उपादानत्व श्रवणात्. श्रुति क्लियरली सेज दैट ब्रह्मन इज जगत उपादानम, इट इज द मटेरियल कॉज ऑफ द क्रिएशन. इन छांदोग्य तावानस्य महिमा, इन ऑल दोस पैसेजेस, दिस इज ऑल महिमा ऑफ ब्रह्मन. सो दिस इज ग्लोरी ऑफ ब्रह्मन. बट then now Shruti says two things. Not only is Brahman the upadana karanam, but Brahman is different from Jagat. You see, that also Shruti says. That's an important point to note. That clay, if there is upadana karanam, material cause of the pot, then clay is no more separate from pot. After creating pot, clay is no more separate. Here we are told that even after creating Jagat, Brahman remains separate from the Jagat. So, tavanasya mahimatta ityadau karya vyatarekena satta shravanat. This is the glory of Brahman. Etavanasya mahima ato jayagumsa purushah. This universe is of course the glory of Brahman, but it is even transcends it. So, Shruti also shows that Brahman is transcendental. Brahman is both immanent, all-pervasive, as well as transcendental. So, we go by Shruti. Right now, this is a paksha that is taken. We simply go by what the Upanishad says. Upanishad says that Brahman remains different from Jagat. Brahman transcends Jagat. Therefore, na krishna prasaktihi. Therefore, Brahman is not undergone entirely the transformation in the form of Jagat. Shabda Moolatvat. And you cannot arrive at the nature of Brahman by reasoning. For establishing or knowing the nature of Brahman, the Shruti is the Pramanam and not logic or Yukti is not the Pramanam. Yukti or logic should follow the Shruti. Not the Shruti should be interpreted based on the Yukti. The Yukti should be supplied to support the Shruti. So, Shabda Moolatvat, Brahmana, Shabdaika Pramanatvat. Brahman is merely known through Shabda or Shruti or through Upanishad. Na Yuktya Shrutehe Badaha. Your Yukti is what? The Brahman is Niravayavam, then wholesale transformation. Savayavam, then it will contradict what the Upanishad says. So by Yukti, you are contradicting what the Shruti says. That cannot be. Shruti says that Brahman is Jagat Karanam and Brahman is transcendent also. अथो यथाश्रुति ब्रह्मणः कार्योपादानत्वं तद्व्यतिरेकेण सत्वं च अविरुद्धम्. सो स्लोली नाउ वी आर कमिंग दैट अतः यथाश्रुति इन कीपिंग विद श्रुति ब्रह्मणः कार्योपादानत्वं. ब्रह्मन इज कार्यस्य उपादानम् इज द मटेरियल कॉज द कार्य ऑफ द जगत ऑफ द यूनिवर्स. Tad bhitarekena sattvam cha, and Brahman exists independent of Jagat. Brahman transcends Jagat. Very peculiar thing now. So far accepting it, Brahman is like clay, the arguments were made. Or Brahman is like a pot maker, the arguments were made. But now, that Brahman is not like clay, it is of a different nature. So now we go to the next sutra. So on the page 401. If you look at Ratna Prabha, the third line of Ratna Prabha, Niravayavasya Vastunaha Kutasthasyapi Avidya Kalpita Nama Rupa Vikara Angikara. Now Vedanta is introducing ignorance. Niravayavasya Vastunaha Kutasthasyapi. Even the Vastu of the reality is Niravayavam, partless, homogeneous. Kutastha, changeless. So now we are talking about Brahman. That's a unique kind of material cause which is changeless. Kutasthasyabhi avidya kalpina nama rupa vikara angikarat. We are saying, not saying that the Jagat is satyam. We are saying that Jagat is mithya. It is what? Avidya. Kalpita nama rupa vikara angikarat. This nama rupa kalpana, because of ignorance, that creation is not that Brahman undergoes a real transformation. Sarupa, it will be said, anupamardhanena, without in fact sacrificing its changelessness, remaining in its own nature, it creates Jagat or becomes Jagat. Meaning that it only appears as Jagat. So therefore, Durghatatva Dosho Nasti. How can Brahman transform itself as Jagat? Says by ignorance, this can happen. Vastava Kautasthasya कल्पित विकार प्रकृतित्वेन अविरोधादित्यर्थः. So thing that is changeless can become the material cause of something which is imagined, not real. A changeless cannot be the material cause of something real. Because material cause must necessarily undergo transformation to become the effect. Like the clay should undergo transformation to become a pot. But this rule applies to the creation which is real. But there is another kind of creation which is not real, which is the product of ignorance. Therefore, it is kalpita, which is imagination, which is mithya. So, Brahma Satyam, Jagan Mithya. Brahman is kutastham, changeless, and Jagat is mithya, or only an appearance. Therefore, the kautasthyam, the changelessness of Brahman, is not in any way sacrificed for being the material cause of that which is mithya. If Brahman were the material cause of Jagat, that is Satyam, then Brahman cannot be kutastha or changeless anymore. But Brahman is the material cause of Jagat, which is mithya, and therefore there is no contradiction. निष्प्रपंच ब्रह्मदिशेषत्वेन सृष्टि अनुद्यते न प्रतिपाद्यते इति. सो वेदांत देन गोज टू द लास्ट एक्सटेंट, सेज व्हेन श्रुति टॉक्स अबाउट क्रिएशन देयर इज नो इंटेंशन ऑफ सेइंग दैट क्रिएशन इज रियल और दैट द क्रिएशन रियली टुक प्लेस. दैट्स नॉट द इंटेंट. दे आर टेलिंग स्टोरीज. But as when you call it cock and bull stories about creation, when the Upanishad of Vedas talk about creation, it is like telling a story. For what is that story told? Nishprapancha Brahma Disheshatvena. That prapancha is mithya. The purpose of describing creation is only to establish that creation is mithya, is not real. And in spite of the creation, Brahman is nishprapancham, meaning it transcends all the prapancha, transcends samsara. Brahman is unaffected, untainted. Srushtihi anudyate, meaning that whenever Upanishads talk about creation, all that is called anuvada. There is no tatparya in creation. Upanishads do not have tatparya or purport in describing a real creation. Because creation is seen, it is merely reiterated that there is creation. Because the student comes to the teacher believing that the creation is real. And for the student, the creation, Jagat, is a big problem because it is real. When something is real, it is going to impact you. It will create in you ragadveshas. Because the real thing can be either favorable or unfavorable. For favorable, there will be attachment or raga. For unfavorable, there will be dvesha, going to be. And the fellow is suffering. So suffering in life is not because there is a reason to suffer, because what is mithya is taken to be satyam. So shochananva shochasam, how to release him from grief? By revealing that there is no cause for grief at all. There is no real death, Arjuna. Na hanyate hanyamane sharire. Ubhau tau na vijanitah nayam hanti na hanyate. Hanta ched manyate hantum hatas ched manyate hatam. Tha yayinam veti hantaram yashinam manyate hatam. So one who thinks that he is killing, other one who feels he is killed, both of them do not know, because Atma doesn't kill nor gets killed. So that is how, that's the last stroke that Vedanta provides here. सृष्टि अनुद्यते न प्रतिपाद्यते. इवन दो देर मे बी एन एलाबोरेट डिस्क्रिप्शन ऑफ क्रिएशन उपनिषद, द इंटेंशन इज नॉट टू डिस्क्राइब अ रियल क्रिएशन, इट इज मेयरली टू डिस्क्राइब इन सच ए वे दैट द स्टूडेंट कैन सी दैट द क्रिएशन इज मिथ्या. निष्प्रपंच ब्रह्मदिशेषत्वेन, सो दैट अल्टीमेटली वन रियलाइज इज दैट ऑल दैट इज ब्रह्मन. इति असकृत आवेदितम्, वी हैव सेड दिस वेरी ऑफन ऑलरेडी. अतः विवर्तवादे न कश्चित् दोषः इति. देयरफॉर इवन द भाष्यकार डज नॉट यूज द वर्ड विवर्त, दैट केम लेटर ऑन इज अ प्रक्रिया. बट वॉट एवर क्वेश्चन यू रेज अबाउट ब्रह्मन बीइंग द मटेरियल कॉज, those questions have no place if you accept vivartavada. So page 401 we are reading, if you look at Ratna Prabha, purvavastha nashena avasthantaram parinama, the definition of what is transformation, parinama. Purvavastha nashena avasthantaram, that the earlier state is destroyed and a new state is created, that's called parinama or transformation. Meaning that the milk is no more there, the avastha called milk is no more there, the new avastha called curd comes into being. Pura avastha nashena, by the elimination or destruction of the previous state, the new state is created, avasthan, that is called parinamah. Yatha dugdasya dadibhavah, a standard example, just as a milk undergoes transformation to become curd. Pura rupa anupamardena avasthantaram vivartah. Pura rupa anupamardena, but without giving up its own previous state. So, getting transformed into another state without changing the previous state. So, when previous state changes, a new state comes, then it's a standard example of parinama or transformation. But when the previous stage doesn't change and a new stage comes, yatha shuktehe rajata bhavah, just as a shell, remaining shell, becomes silver, or as though becomes silver, appears as silver. This is the example of the vivarta. So slowly discussion is now veered towards vivarta. Says Ratnava, tatra brahmanah vivarta upadanatvam svapna sakshi drishtantena drudayan dradayan. Sutrakara is himself now accepting vivartavada. That's what they say. Tatra brahmana vivarta upadanatvam dradayan. Even the previous sutra also indicated that brahman is vivarta upadanakaranam. It is the material cause without undergoing any change. Dradayan, that is now, so that argument is now firmed up. By what? Within an illustration. So having provided the hetu, now you, I mean provided the reason, pratignya, you must provide the hetu, I mean ahetu, or the example or the illustration. Svapna sakshi drishtantena. So this sutra gives the drishtanta, illustration of svapna sakshi, of the dreamer. Mayavadam sphutayati, you call it avivartavada or mayavada. What is maya? Maya is the cause of mithya. Mithya means appearance. Appearance can only be caused by maya, something like magic. Like a magician creates an appearance of what is not there, and so also यद असत भासमानम तन मिथ्या विच इज नॉट देयर इन रियालिटी विच अपीयर्स टू बी देयर दैट्स कॉल्ड मिथ्या. स्वप्न गजादिवत लाइक द एलिफेंट्स एटसेट्रा इन द ड्रीम सो ऑल्सो वॉट इज नॉट देयर अपीयरेंस ऑफ दैट इज कॉल्ड मिथ्या. सो बाय द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ ड्रीमर ऑफ द ड्रीम वर्ल्ड द सूत्रकार ऑल्सो फर्म्स अप the vivartavada or mayavada. Mayavada means that maya is a primary cause, material cause and not brahman. So brahman is material cause and still not material cause. How can you explain that? Brahman is material cause because Upanishad says that, but it cannot be material cause in primary sense because then it should undergo a change which it does not. That also Shruti says that Brahman is still separate from Jagat. It transcends the Jagat. So Brahman should be both immanent, all-pervasive, as well as transcendent. How can that be? Only Brahman is material cause, is not material cause simultaneously. Brahman is simultaneously material cause as well as not material cause. Then what is so primarily Maya is a material cause. Then why do you call Brahman material cause? Because without Brahman, presence of Brahman, Maya cannot do anything. Maya adhyakshena prakriti suyate sacharacharam. Hetunanena kaunteya jagat viparivartate. Maya adhyakshena. I am an adhyaksha, I am the sakshi, I am the witness, I am the illumining factor. I am just a presence, a conscious presence, self-revealing presence. In my presence, the maya creates and sustains and dissolves, all that play goes on. The Brahman is called jagat karanam, cause of creation only in a secondary sense, not in a primary sense. मम योनिर्महद्ब्रह्म तस्मिन् गर्भं दधाम्यहम्. ब्रह्मन् इज मा योनि इन विच आई इंजेक्ट द गर्भ. सो विदाउट मी नथिंग कैन हैपन. देयरफॉर अल्टीमेटली द बक स्टॉप्स हियर. दे से यू नो वेयर शुड द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी अल्टीमेटली वेयर शुड इट स्टॉप. माया सेज आई डोंट आई एम इनर्ट आई कांट डू एनीथिंग. So Maya will point out to Brahman. So Brahman ultimately said the Jagat Karana. Brahman says, don't bother me, don't tell me, because I have nothing within me to become Jagat Karanam. Therefore Maya is the primary cause and Brahman is in a secondary sense the cause of creation. This is the Vedantic position about the relationship between Brahman and Jagat as a cause and the effect, a unique kind of cause called Vivarta Upadana Karanam. So this next sutra, Sutra 28. Atmani cha evam vichitraschahi आत्मनि च एवं विचित्राः च हि. लास्ट वर्ड ही यस्मात् न तत्र रथाः न योगाः इत्यादेहि. आत्मनि स्वप्नदृशि एकस्मिन् आत्मनि विचित्राः विविधाः सृष्टयः श्रूयन्ते. अंडरस्टैंड द उपनिषद इटसेल्फ टॉक्स अबाउट ड्रीम. In Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, elaborate discussion is there about dream. Na tatra yarathaha, na ratha yogaha. In the dream, this person creates the chariots and horses and the paths and everything which are not there. Ityadau atmani, sutra is atmani svapna drushi in the dreamer. एकस्मिन् आत्मने आत्मा अस्वप्न ड्रीमर हु इज वन विचित्राः विविधाः सृष्टयः श्रूयन्ते. A variegated creation is said to be there in the dream. Chakara, the loke mayavini sarupa anupamardeneiva hastyashwadi vichitraha srishtayo drishyante. Or in the our day-to-day life also, like a juggler or a magician, mayavini sarupa anupamardeneiva, the mayavi or the magician, it remains and appears as elephant, appears as horse. So whatever kind of magic shows Bhashyakara must have seen those days. But then very often different descriptions are there. So how mayavi or a magician, without giving up its own nature, creates elephants and horses, means creates appearance of elephants and horses. Evam ekasmin brahmani api vivida srishti bhavitum arhati. Similarly, even though Brahman is one, there can be a variegated creation. Says Nyayanirne, Sutrartham Vivrunvan Drishtanda Sadbhavad Vivartavade Vivado Nasti. See, when you make any claim, you must also give an apt illustration. Where do you see this? You talk of Vivartavada, where the material cause does not undergo transformation to become the effect. Where do you see that? Drishtanta Sadbhavat, because there is Drishtanta. Therefore, Vivartavade Vivado Nasti, there can be any dispute as far as the Vivartavada or the position of the Vivarta is concerned. Apiche Bhashyakara says, Apiche Naiva Atre Vivaditavyam Katham Ekasmin Brahmane Swarupa Anupamarde Naiva Aneka Kara Srishtisya Dede. Apicha, furthermore, Naivatra Vivaditavyam, with reference to this topic, with reference to this principle, this Siddhanta, Nai Vivaditavyam, there should be no vivada, there should be no dispute. Katham ekasmin brahmani sarva anumardenaiva anekakara srishtisyaditi. How Brahman, remaining one, without a second, still swarupa anumardenaiva, without the destruction of or change in its own original nature. Anekakara srishti syat. So Brahman, without undergoing any transformation, how can it create or how can it become the variegated universe? With reference to that, there should be no dispute at all. Vivadasya akartavyatve hetumaha. Why should vivada not be done? Say, hey, there is no scope for vivada or dispute here, or argument. Why should there be no arguments? So says Vashyakara, यतः आत्मनि अपि एकस्मिन् स्वप्नदृशे स्वरूप अनुपमर्देनैव अनेकाकारा सृष्टिः पठ्यते. यतः आत्मनि अपि, सूत्रकारस्य आत्मनि दृष्टांत आष्टांतिक एकार्थत्वं विशिनष्टि. Drishtanta is dreamer. Therefore, ekasmin svapna drishe. Sutra only is Atman in the self. In the self also we see this variegated creation. When do you see? In the dream. Atmani means ekasmin svapna drishe. Even though dreamer is one. Sarupa anumardeneva, the dreamer, without giving up its own nature, anekakara srushti pathyate. We see that the srushti creation is variegated creation is seen in the dream, without the dreamer sacrificing its own nature. Pathyate. See, it says here, Nyayanirne, Swapnasya Smrutitva Abhyupagamana. About dream also there are disputes. Swapnasya Smrutitva Abhyupagamana. Somebody says that dream is just a memory of what has already happened. Viruddha Sushtiyeva Tatra Nastiti. So dream is not a creation, it's just a memory. Kutosya Dushtandatayati. How can you present dream as an example when it's not a creation, just a memory? Iti Ashankya Aparokshataya Swapnasya Asmrutitvam Abhipretya. Aparokshataya. Smruti is always paroksha. Memory is always remote, meaning that when you remember something, you see, when you remember something that you experienced in the past, in your mind there is understanding that this is paroksha jnanam, this is indirect knowledge, there is a remoteness involved. That you recollect a certain person, you know, which you met 10 years ago, and then when you think about that, there is a remoteness involved. There is no directness involved. But when you are experiencing dream, you don't think that you are experiencing something remote, you are experiencing something that is immediate. So aparokshataya, smruti is always paroksha, dream is aparoksham, and therefore svapnasya asmrutitvam, therefore svapna is not a memory, it is an experience. So pathyate, this is what Shruti says, pathyate. Na tatra rathaha, na rathayogaha, na panthano bhavante, atha rathan rathayogan pathah srujate ityadina. Na tatra swapne, in the dream, na tatra rathaha, there are no chariots, na rathayogaha. What is rathayoga? Says Ratna Prabha, rathayoga ashvaha. There are no horses. So that which is joined with ratha, and so horses. Na panthana, there are no paths. So in the dream you are experiencing that you are riding a chariot which is pulled by horses, which is running on the roads. In the dream, where the dream takes place, in a very small nerve the dream takes place. In that nadi or the nerve, there is no scope for the chariot or horses and the roads and the whole world that you see, there is no scope. Which is what you realize when you wake up. When you wake up, you realize that this was just a Brahma, only a delusion and not a reality, because in your mind you are dreaming where there is no scope. So, na tatra rathaha, na rathayogaha, na panthano bhavanti. In the dream, there are no chariots, no horses, and no paths or no roads. Atha rathan rathayogan pathah srujate. But this dreamer creates the chariots and horses and the roads. Ityadina pathyate. First, swapne rathadina abhave katham tat prathayati. First, the Shruti says there are no chariots, no horses, no roads. then how do you say that, see that in the dream? Atha srujate. The dreamer, in fact, creates us. He is the creator, understand? That is why the example. So srujate, it says, the dreamer creates the chariots and horses and the paths, and not just see something which is already there. There are so many views about dream. One view is that the dreamer sees what is there. One view is that it's a memory. Other view is that it is real experience. Says no, srujate, he creates what is not there. Atmani chaiti vyakhyaya vichitrashahi iti vyajaste. Sutra has two elements there. Atmani cha eva vichitrashahi. So, Atmani means within the self, that is in the dreamer. But not only dreamer, there are other examples as well. Subhashyakar explains that. Lokepi devadishu maya vyadishu cha swarupa anupamarde naiva vichitraha hastyashwadi srushtayah drishyante. Lokepi devadishu, devatas are able to create the variegated universe, variegated things. Maya vyadishu loke, then we have to understand loke means in shastra. In the mantra, arthavada, ityasa, purana, in all of this, you hear about the devatas and pitrus and rishis creating. So vichitra, variegated things, that is there. Or loke means our day-to-day experience, maya vyadishu in a magician, etc. Swarupa anumardeneva, without sacrificing its original nature. Hastyashwadi srushtayo drishyante. So we also see that magician creates an elephant, magician creates a horse. Magician remains what he is and creates all of this. So vichitraha, all variegated creation, is experienced in the day-to-day life also. Evam, that's the third. Atmanicha is explained. Vichitrasya is explained. Evam, thus. So that is darshtandika. Evam is sutrapadam vyakurvan. Dashtantika maha, in this manner, the creation also, Brahman also. Tathayati. So Vashyakara says, Tatha ekasmin napi brahmane swarupa anupamarde naiva anekakara srushtir bhavishyati te. So that's darshtanta. Svapna is drishtanta, or deva or maya is drishtanta, and brahman is darshtanta. Tatha ekasmin api brahmani. Tatha means similarly evam, or tatha similarly ekasmin api brahmani. Even the brahman is one, non-dual. Swarupa anupamarde naiva. You see, all of these you have to, this is all interpretation of Shruti, understand? Shruti doesn't say exactly, you know, what creation is real, unreal. What you have to derive from what the Shruti says. Tasmad vai tasmad atmana akasha sambhuta. From atma, how can akasha come? Atma being satyam, jnana, anantam, brahma, in skutastha, changeless, how can akasha come? Only way it can come is akash is an appearance, not a reality. So that is how the whole Vedanta Siddhanta is derived from the Shruti. That is the reason why the same statements can be interpreted differently by different acharyas to arrive at their prakriyas. But there is nothing comparable to what the Vedanta says. And so, From analyzing these statements of Shruti, it becomes very clear that Jagat has to be Mithya. And just as from the gold undergoes variety of stages to become a chain, at every stage is gold, so also Brahman undergoes Akasha, Vayu, Agni, etc. and becomes a universe. At every stage it is Brahman. Gold alone appears as a raw bar, and appears as a rod, and appears as wire, and appears as rings, and appears as chain. So Brahman alone appears as Akasha, Vayu, Agni, etc. What there is Brahman. Sarvam Khalvidam Brahma. There must be consistency. It can't be Shruti saying one thing in one place and something else in another place. In one place Shruti says all there is Brahman. Elsewhere says there is Akasha, Vayu. How can it be? Unless they are also Brahman. Meaning Brahman appearing as them. So that is how we arrive at Vivarta, Vada, etc. Meaning these are all models. Vivarta also is a model. So Shuktika Rajata is an example. How Shuktika or a shell, without undergoing change, appears as silver. Satha ekasminapi brahmane. Similarly, Brahman, even though it is one, Swarupa anumardeneva, without sacrificing its own true nature of kautasthyam, changelessness, and homogeneity, changelessness, niravayavatvam, kutasthatvam, nityatvam, then nishkalam, what is it, nishkalam, nishkalatvam, nishkriyatvam, without sacrificing anything, anekakara srushti bhavishyati. Like the dreamer can create, Brahman also can create. So dream becomes a very good model for the creation of mithya. Iti shabda vivartavada samaptyartha. What iti is? So vivartavada discussion came, is concluded with the word iti. Okay. Tomorrow we'll take the two more sutras are remaining now. 33 and 34, three are remaining. So tomorrow we'll take up the 30 and then 33. Okay. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Shankaram Shankaracharyam Keshavam Badarayanam. Sutra Bhashya Kritau Vande Bhagavantau Punah Punah. Ishvaro Guru Ratmeri Vibhagine Vyomavat Vyapta Dehaya Dakshinamurtaye Namah. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.